Hi guys, back again with another video. I just want to show you this plaque that I redid. This was mine back when I was like a baby, and this is what it looked like before. It was white base with the letters in blue and green. Here's a ladybug on the eye, and I took this when I was in the middle of scanning the letters, and I thought, oh, I better take a picture of it from before, from the before stage. So I took it off the computer, laptop, and this is what it looks like now. I scanned the letters, but then I realized that like maybe I could take the letters off, and I took the E off, and it came off pretty easily. Same with the H and the I, and then had problems with the R and the S. Well, the S it came up, but then like right here where it's covered up, it cracked, broke off, and with the R, a lot of it was still attached to it, but this part came out fine, and still came up. You can see, you know, where there's still wood on the base. I just sanded it really good. There, and I have like injuries trying to pry the these two letters off. And so anyway, I sanded the letters, and then I primed the base with gesso, and I primed the letters with gesso, let them dry overnight, and then I took I took magenta craft paint and did a couple layers on that and let that dry. And then I took black craft paint and let that dry. And then today I took, after it dried, I took the base and I sprayed some glimmer mist to seal it with a kiss on it, and then smushed it around my finger. I did it on both sides, front and back, and then I took some tissue paper and stamped some images, and I used matte medium to glue it down. And then because it looked stark white, I took glitter mist again and sprayed the heck out of it. And I took Luminaire Arts, the shimmering mist, the pink grapefruit. I spread that on there, and I, you know, moved it around and with the heat gun, and so it don't look, you know, the edges and the tissue paper don't look so white, and it sort of blends in more. Oh, and then before I painted, I did take these off. Off. And then for the letters, I painted them black, and then I used Raven Glimmer Mist and Pearl Glimmer Mist. And then I heat set it with the heat gun, and then when it started to bubble up, you know, the black paint started to bubble up, I stopped. And then I was trying to figure out how to glue the letters down. And I thought glossy accents, and that didn't really work. My concern was for the S and the R. So then I decided to use hot glue, and that worked. Hopefully it won't be. You can see like there's space, you know, with the hot glue. especially here. This took a couple tries. And then I realized I could have used, or hope maybe used, like the super glue that I have. But I didn't use that, so if they fall off again, if they come off, I'll probably try that. So then I wanted to cover up, you know, where the cracks are. And I took the butterfly off, but there was like a little bit of the wood left. Not from the ladybug, not butterfly. So I was looking to cover, you know, the errors, the flaws. And first I made flowers and made three. So I was going to put one here, and then one in between here. And it just didn't look right, and it wasn't really me. So then I was looking around, and I saw these charms that I had gotten from Michael's, like, last year, I think. And they're somewhat more me, so I just, you know, stuck them on with the super glue. And I really liked how it turned out, especially where it was. There it is now. So that's my little video, my little share, and I haven't really been crafting much. This is the first major thing I've done since I went down, put all my stuff downstairs. I haven't really felt like doing anything. I don't know if it's because I'm down, my stuff's down there, and it's cold, or what. My mojo ain't feeling it down there. So thanks for watching.